Hi there. This is just a quick video showing you a technique that I use, a workflow for Lightroom that gets around Lightroom's problem with using a lot of RAM. Lots of people experience when they have large catalogs, lots of pictures, lots of previews built. Lightroom slows down. It's primarily due to overusage of RAM and the size of the database as it's loading in the images, the catalog. So I use a workflow that gets around this quite effectively. Let's just have a look at how much RAM Lightroom is currently using. So I have Lightroom using 700 megabytes of RAM. What I have here is the images I'm working on today from a recent shoot around Dublin City Centre. So I'll just run from start to finish of how I get my images into Lightroom and how I keep the catalog size down. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to Windows Explorer and I go to my computer. I've inserted the memory card from my camera. I don't let Lightroom import the pictures directly into the catalog automatically. I prefer to do that manually. It gives me the opportunity to name folders and incorporate this into my workflow for backup and, in the worst case, data recovery. So what I usually do is I rename, sorry, let's show you. All my images are here. So I usually rename the folder on the memory card with the date. So this is the 13th, and I will give it a name, and I believe this was Dublin Streets. Okay, once the folder isn't renamed, still on the memory card, I cut the folder. You can do this right-clicking and cut. And I place it onto my local computer, which would be a lot faster than editing it from the card. So on my C drive, I have my photography folder. And I'll just paste it there. It transfers the images off the memory card, ready to be processed in Lightroom. The advantage of doing it this way is, independent of Lightroom, I have all my images organized into distinct folders with descriptions and dates. I can sort them on date. It'll automatically, the date format I've chosen is year, month, day, in numeric format. And then a quick description of what the shoot entailed. Okay, so as I said, this was my previous shoot that I was doing, so I want to work on a completely different one. When you have the one big catalog, you generally just go and browse to other images within your library. In my case, I need to start a new catalog. So choose File, New Catalog, and I'm just going to browse to my photography folder. And the folder I just created there that I took off the memory card. Fantastic. And I pick the same name for all my catalogs. And as they're stored with the images in the image folder in my photographic archive, I just pick C80 for catalog. And I'll just skip that. So Lightroom relaunches with a brand new fresh catalog. There should be nothing in here. So let's have a look at the memory usage before we do anything. And Lightroom is currently 172 megabytes. This is a far cry from 8 gigabytes, 10 gigabytes, 12 of large Lightroom catalogs. But we haven't imported any images yet, so let's do that. So I'm just going to go to Import. And I will select the images I want to import. And I believe they're in here. That all looks good. Just go and port every image here. Great. Okay. So first thing I do after importing the images is I select all the images, Control A, and I want to apply my metadata. I've have a metadata template for my copyright descriptions, etc. There are plenty of guides on YouTube on how to create metadata templates. So I just have one here called Seb, and all selected as I selected all. And this has applied template. It's removed any descriptions that the camera had put onto the images, and it's applied my copyright notice, which all my images that I have online are public domain and the creator's name. Okay, so I effectively have all my images inside Lightroom now. I can do my selections, do my editing, run through develop, essentially whatever I want to do as normal. I can generate all my full previews. If you generate full previews, they'll be stored inside that specific folder beside the catalog. I will go into there now, show you. So Dublin Streets 2 is what I was working on. So when you generate previews or when you're editing, all data is stored inside a specific cat folder. This makes it very handy to back up, transfer to other computers, package up and give to friends if they have Lightroom and they want to edit the pictures or continue on the editing. If you are working in professional capacity, for moving it all self-contained to a distinct backup system, or giving it to a colleague for them to continue the editing. This allows you to have everything packaged up by the date, with a description, completely self-contained. As the catalogs are smaller, more efficient, faster, and they have less images, there's less chance of corruption. So I'll just show you now here. Let's go through and edit as normal. So I just want to show you how much memory. So for this very small shoot, Adobe Lightroom is using 1.3 gigabytes. It'll rarely go above this for this amount of images. So when I'm finished editing all my images, I'm just going to show you with an example here. I'm just going to deselect these and select three images or four and file, export. So I'm just going to export at full resolution. So I just want to remove, I had some restrictions in here before for publishing to the web. So I'm going to export now. And what I've set to export to same folder as original photos into export, full resolution, as there is no resolution constraints. Okay, just exporting. Take a moment. Apologies, this laptop is quite slow. Very slow today. Okay, great. So we just jump back in here and we see our export folder. We see all our images. And we should be able to see our metadata inserted in. Great. Same thing again. Everything is self-contained. Everything can be copied to a different computer. One photographic session after the other. Okay, that's just my quick video explaining a simple workflow that gets around Adobe's massive memory usage.